Hi children, how are you? This is your math teacher Kalyan Babu sir. In this video I am going to discuss about HCF of two numbers by using Euclid's division lemma. In previous class I just discussed about the definition of Euclid's division lemma. When we recall Euclid's division lemma again, the actual division we can write in other process. That other process is called Euclid's division lemma. The actual process is they will give dividend and divisor. So we have to divide and find quotient and remainder. This is actual division. But this actual division we write in other way. That way is dividend equal to divisor into quotient plus remainder. I am going to write this dividend. Dividend is equal to divisor into quotient plus remainder. This process is called as Euclid's division lemma. By using Euclid's division lemma, means by using this rule, find the HCF of two numbers. 50, 70 is there. Find the HCF of 50, 70, 96 and 72, 300 and 550. Find the HCF. What is the full form of HCF? Highest common factor. Find the highest common factor of 50, 70 by using Euclid's division lemma. So now I am going to start to find the HCF of 50, 70. First problem is HCF of 50, 70 by using Euclid's division lemma. Euclid's division lemma. By using Euclid's division lemma, I am going to find HCF. So first children, you take the bigger number. What is the bigger number in between? 70. Very good. 70 is the bigger number. And draw two lines like this. And take the smaller number 50. And divide with 50 table. How many times it goes? 52's are 100. So that it is not possible. So 51's are will satisfy. 51's are 50. After subtraction we get 20. 20 is the remainder. So now for this division, write Euclid's division lemma. So what is dividend here? 70 is the dividend. So 70 is equal to, what is the divisor? 50 is the divisor. 50 into, what is the quotient? Quotient is 1. 1 is the quotient. Plus, what is remainder? Remainder is 20. So 51's of 50, 50 plus 20, 70. This rule is called as Euclid's division lemma. But we not find HCF here. Again we continue the division. How means? Now 20 is the remainder. 20 is the remainder here. But we have to get the remainder is 0. So till get 0, you do the division again. So again you draw two lines here. Bring down this 50 here. Bring down 50 in that place. And divide with the 20 table now. How many times it goes? I think it is 22's are 40. 22's are 40. After subtraction we get 10. 10 is the remainder. For this process also, you apply Euclid's division lemma again. Dividend. Dividend is 50 now. Dividend is 50. Divisor. Divisor is 20 into quotient is 2. place, remainder is 10. 10 is the remainder. Come on, try to balance this 22s of 40. 40 plus 10, 50 again. Yes, this is Euclid's division lemma. Again we got remainder is 10 here. Means up to get as a 0, again you do the division again. 10 is the divisor, bring down 20 to this place. Now how many times it goes? 10 twos are 20. Yes, now we got the remainder as 0. Now the problem is completed. Again write the Euclid's division lemma. Dividend, what is the dividend here? 20 is the dividend. 10 into 2 plus what is the remainder? 0. Now the problem is completed. In which table the division is satisfied? Means in which table the division leaves the remainder 0? In which table it leaves the remainder 0? I think in 50 table? No. 20 table? No. In which table it leaves the remainder 0? In 10 table which leaves the remainder 0. So that 10 is the highest common factor of 50, 70. So 50 is not HCF, 20 is not HCF. Now what is the HCF means? 10 is the HCF of 50, 70. So finally I am going to write HCF. HCF of 50, 70 is 10. So this is the process of finding HCF by using Euclid's division lemma. Did you understand this? Very good. I think you understand. One more problem is there. Second problem. Find the HCF of 96, 72. 96, 72. So here already you write dividend equal to divisor into quotient plus remainder. This rule is called as Euclid's division lemma. Now take the two numbers again. What is the bigger number in 96 and 72? The bigger number is 96. Take 72, that is the smaller number. Do the division with 72 table. I think it will divide with only ones. 72 ones of 72. And do the subtraction. 6 minus 2, 4. 9 minus 7, 2. So here, we not get 0. Remainder is not equal to 0. So then write the Euclid's division process. 96. Dividend is 96. Divisor is 72. Quotient is 1. What is the remainder? 24. 24 is the remainder. Again you do the division till to get the remainder as 0. 72. How many times it goes? Is it possible to 3 table? 3 fours are 12. 3 twos are 6 plus 1, 7. Yes, very good. We got the remainder as 0. In second step only we got the remainder 0 here. So write the dividend is 72 and divisor is 24. Quotient is 3 and what is the remainder? 0. Yes. In second equation we got remainder as 0. So now what is the HCF? HCF of 96, 72 is in which table we got remainder as 0? 72 table? No. In 24 table we got the remainder as 0. So that 24 is the HCF of 96, 72. This is the process of finding highest common factor by using Euclid's division lemma. don't we neglect these problems? We have so many problems in our 10th class math textbook. So work out all the problems from try this, do this, and also examples, exercise problems. Don't waste your time. Be serious on your studies. Take care. We meet again in the next video. Thank you for listening. We meet again. Thank you.